Contemplation Fighters. Hope you're doing well and feeling blessed. Still tired today, but I did manage to get some things done. First of all, I want to talk about repurposing some things. We don't have like a cupcake carrier or anything like that, so we are going to use one of these, which I have many of. So it should hold probably about a dozen in here. Just line the bottom with some parchment paper, and I'll put some over the top if I need it. But this is going to work fantastically for that purpose. So there's repurposing for you. So one of the areas that I deep cleaned today, well, I've created a routine. So what I do is I pick a room of the house every day and I do something to deep clean that room. And today it was the kitchen sink. There was a lot of calcium buildup there. So I just, having been a professional cleaner for 6 years, well, and longer than that if you count having to clean for the daycare that I worked for or when I was in preschool at home, you know, there's certain standards you have to meet. So at any rate, oftentimes I would go into a place and their sink was just terrible. And I mean, every stainless sink has, I mean, you can get it polished, you can get it matted, you can just, you know, so there's different methods to use for cleaning, for deep cleaning. So the only two items that I used on my sink today was this stuff that I can get at the Dollar Tree. It's called Totally Awesome. I still have about that much left in here. I clean the spout, the sprayer, in around the faucet, around the sprayer, clean the faucet, clean the rest of the sink, obviously. But it needed to get rid of that calcium. And this stuff worked actually pretty good. So you'll need this, and probably just to do a kitchen sink, I would say 4 rags. So after you do this, and I hung down a dish towel behind the faucet just so I wasn't going to get any of that on the wall or things like that. So after you do this part, get a washcloth wet, very wet, dripping wet, and wipe down everything. Then, it's almost like a rinse. Then take Dawn, and I don't use anything but Dawn for certain jobs. This was an item that, it's hard to find anything that's better than this, actually, which is why I have it. But, at any rate, you take a soapy cloth then and go over all of what you just rinsed, separate cloth. Then take a towel and dry it. And, or, you know, take your wet rag and go over it again and then dry it with a different washcloth. Now, one of the tricks I learned with some of the styles of sinks that we had is I would use stainless steel polish or cleaner on it when it was completely dry. And it just, I mean, the sink almost looked brand new. I loved that. Deep cleaning is one of my favorite things to do. So, two things that often get overlooked when you're cleaning the sink are these guys, your drain catchers, and your drain plugs. It's a part that gets missed a lot, but honestly, it's so easy to clean. So all I did was put direct on a washcloth some Dawn and go entirely along the inside of this, the outside, lift it up if there's room and get that screw that's in here, and then this little tapper part right here, and rinse it off and dry it. And it sometimes it can look brand new, especially if you polished it afterwards. It would look brand new. And as far as the plastic thing, I wouldn't use this on plastic. I just used Dawn and, you know, cleaned out everything inside. So it's a part that gets overlooked. And if you're doing your dishes in there frequently, I mean, you're doing them in with something grimy and gross, you know. Even if you rinse it well, still, the sink isn't, I don't consider that to be clean. But I didn't do the washing of my reusable bags today because I wanted to get that sink totally clean before I did it. So that'll be the next thing that I do. But it just, it feels so nice to know that that sink is as clean as it is, and it would look brand new if anybody came to see it. So I should have done a before and after video, and maybe next time I do something with a deep clean, I will show you. Maybe I'll do a little before and then an after on that. We're at 95 subscribers, so welcome and thank you everybody for tuning in and checking here. Five more and I try the live thing. We'll see if that happens. But at any rate, tomorrow is going to be meal planning day and meal planning from the pantry, obviously. And two things I wanted to mention. So I started my onions in the slow cooker, my caramelized onions in the slow cooker, later in the day. So this meant I'd have to stay up later to finish them off. Well, I didn't. I fell asleep and I got up in the morning and there was nothing but charred crisp everywhere. It made me very sad to think I wasted an entire bag of onions that way, but it happens. So, you know, you move on. But I've learned, you know, if I'm doing that, I'm gonna start it earlier in the day. And the other thing I wanted to mention is that we found out about the cost for getting the natural gas hookups here. And we don't need a loan. We're gonna be able to figure something out other than that. So that turned out to be, thank you God, a great bit of news to get. And shocking, because it was such a small percentage of what it cost our neighbor to do it, but he was the first one to get it done here, so it cost more. So my husband decided what he's going to do, even though he knows we don't legally owe the neighbor guy anything for this. He's gonna do some gestures in kindness, go over and check his furnace, do those kind of things for free. Just as a, you know, because he knows how much it ended up costing, or at least that's how much the neighbor told. Who can say if it really is that much? So at any rate, we're gonna be able to do that, which we're excited about. And hopefully that'll help our heating costs. What I will be most pleased about is the fact that the natural gas comes directly to the house from the service company. You don't have to call the service company, ask them to come and fill a tank, wait, you know, try to figure out, well, how long will it take for them to get here? And gauge the percentage that's left inside of the tank. So that was a bit of good news. And yes, the energy levels are higher. So, and the positivity is going up. So thank you if anybody's prayed. I really, really appreciate it. So for now, until tomorrow, be well, be blessed, and know you're taken care of. Bye for now.